It is Kevin and Bean broadcasting live from the Weenie Roast 2011, and we have the Airborne Toxic Event sitting here with us.
How about that? Hi, guys. How are you?
Hello. Thanks for having us.
Exhausted. What?
Why are you exhausted? It's like 2 o'clock in the afternoon. How tired can you be?
We've already been on tour for like 3.5 months. Our record's only been out for a couple weeks, but we've already been on tour since like January.
I'm looking at your upcoming dates. It seems like you have like 10 shows a day.
Yeah, I know.
Who's booking you? Are they trying to kill you?
I think they are, actually. Like, we have a really mean booking agent that's pissed at us right now.
But don't you think to yourselves, it's hard work, but this is what we wanted. This
Absolutely.
We asked for this,
of
right?
Of course, 100%. Yeah. And then you wake up the next morning and you go, what am I doing?
Wow. Now, the Airborne Toxic event, not only if you guys remember from the last time you came in and played live on the Kevin and Bean Show, an album that I have been in love with since the minute I heard it, has Kat Corbett, who got you on the Locals Only.
Yeah, she was a big part of the whole thing.
We fell in love with the first album, and the second album is just as good. But it's so gratifying for us to see bands come up like you guys, homegrown.
Yeah.
You get played on the Locals Only, you get a little bit of airplay on K-Rock, next thing you know, you're big, 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 and soon you'll be so popular you won't even talk to us anymore.
That's true. It's now.
When does that happen? I'm looking forward.
You are. You're looking forward. Hey, you're walking out. Hey,
we're
leaving.
Come back.
That was a joke. Yeah, you can't wait to
what
start dissing
dick.
Your hometown station, right? Exactly.
Sorry, I've always wanted to do that.
Is this this point where you're at, where you're so busy, is this about what you expected it would be like, or are you still surprised?
We were surprised as shit with all the, like, the whole tickets situation and all the people that have come into shows and the record debuting so high. Like, we didn't expect any of that. We weren't sure if, like, you know, it was all just kind of... Yeah, you know, we had a good little 10 minutes in the sun, and
you
that was
peaked
it, you know?
And you went, most
yeah,
people don't even
man,
peak,
and then
so.
It's like, fuck those we're guys.
We're good.
And wait, I can't swear. Can't
no,
I?
You can. We're recording it.
Oh, awesome. Fuck those guys.
Fuck those guys.
There is also the fear, hey, did we get lucky on the first record?
Yeah.
Now the pressure's on
totally.
Because, you know, the old adage in the music industry, you got your whole life to make your debut
That's
and a
right.
year to make the next one.
That's
so what
right.
do we do now? What was it like for you guys going back in the studio for round two?
It was a lot of work.
Yeah.
It's like actually like a lot of work. We spent a year making that record, wrote about 50 songs for it,
50.
And then had the biggest prick of a producer who was actually really talented, but a total prick.
Fuck him,
like,
too?
No, he was great. Yeah. Dave Sardi is like the most talented guy you will ever work with. But the first day we came in, we played him a song, and literally day one of pre-production, we finished the song. We're all like, yeah, we're sweaty.
Jump
doing
kicking. Doing
yeah,
the whole
and then
thing.
He goes, he's like sitting there like this, and he goes, sweet. So play it again, but this time play like a band that's ever played together before.
Wow.
why a producer needs to have a switchblade in the studio?
Yeah, why do you need a switchblade?
Because
you
know? He's a dick. Yeah. That's no, why he's afraid you guys are going to take a run at him.
He actually pulled a switchblade on Steven. I'm not even
what?
Kidding with
As
you.
As a
swear
joke.
To God.
I was a joke. I was working on a guitar tone, and yeah. he was like, I like the other one better. And I was like, you're the boss. You're the boss.
Dude.
Like,
wow.
Yeah. Yeah. Man, cool.
Well, the new album is out. It is called All At Once. I think, am I high, or does this one rock a little bit harder than the first one?
I think you are high.
Okay. Very possible.
On an unrelated note, yes.
On a related note. Yeah, I think it's bigger and smaller. There's parts of it that are way, way less, like the biggest thing we could think of.
Yeah.
And then some of it, it's just like acoustic guitar and vocal, like little folk song, you know.
Now,
I mean?
Forgive my ignorance for not remembering, but is this your first Weenie Roast?
No, we did it. Second. We did it two years ago.
2 years ago, okay.
Yeah, with like White
and
Lies.
And now you're back,
plays.
And people have heard of you. So
Weezer, yeah, I know, right.
Weezer covered Lady Gaga.
They were like, "Who are these people?"
That's right. They did Shit. Poker Face that year.
They
that's
did
right.
Poker Face. They
and
came out on
and
the couch.
MGMT. They did the
kids.
The
yeah.
They did kids. Yeah, yeah, that's right.
We oh, asked
yeah.
it a single band every year do Poker Face. Can that be you guys?
We wanted to do a CeeLo Green cover, but then we figured everybody was covering.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Well, the album is out, and it is great.
What's the name of that song?
I think it's called Forget You. Or
Forget
you.
Something.
No me recuerdes, I think is what it's called.
The album is out. It is great. It is called All At Once. Pick it up. Give the guys a buck. Download it legally, would you please? Airborne Toxic Event playing the K-Rock Weenie Roast 2011. Great to see you guys. Thank you.
Thank you for having us, guys.